guys. I am here with Yoshi Sudarso, star of the newest film, Buffalo Boys. First and foremost, I got to say, there's two things that were extremely refreshing to me about this movie. Number one, it's a Western. I love Westerns. I grew up on Westerns, and this takes you right back. There's a lot of spaghetti Western tropes. Number two, Asian actors at the front and center. You are the lead in this movie. How does that feel, sir?
Dude, like you said, you loved Westerns. I loved Westerns. Growing up in America, Westerns is a thing. Like, you enjoy that stuff, you know? And it was hard not to ever see, not just be a lead character, not even be one of the smaller characters on the side. The closest we got was Shanghai Noon. And that was like, man, when I saw that, that was, you know.
Wow, like, now that you say that, that's true. Like, that is the closest.
That is the closest that we get. Literally, until, like, you know, the past years we had Magnificent Seven, and he was a dope character, but again, it's like, oh, the only guy who doesn't gunsling.
Sure.
Right? And being called for this, I was like, you're kidding me. I get to be a cowboy? Like, an Asian, real-life cowboy? And not only was it just a cowboy, we didn't wear, like, the dusters kind of thing.
Sure.
We upped it and put, like, leather armor, which was, I think, one of the coolest things about the production design that I was like, done.
But this also stays true to the tropes of being a Western. But you and I were talking off screen about how heavy this movie is. Not only is it fun, but there's a lot of heavy things that are super relatable.
Yes.
There was a great quote that I read that somebody referred to it as almost like an Asian Django Unchained. You know what I mean?
Yeah, absolutely. And that was the thing with Mike, the director. His vision derived a lot from The Good, Bad, and Ugly and Django. Those were the two, like, strongest inspirations, I think, for this film. So
I want to ask you about some of the inspiration you took for Suo, right? Is that his name?
Suo.
Because I know that you have a brother, and you play the younger brother in this, though.
I do.
But talk to me about that character and kind of how you relate to him and parallel him in such a way.
I parallel Suo in the sense that, you know, I was born in Indonesia, moved to America at a young age, you know. I am like 100% to me American, you know, but still don't belong here. And then Suo has to deal with that. And then when I go back to Indonesia following this film, I didn't belong there either. And I felt weird. And Suo goes through all of that in this whole movie. Luckily for him, it's just one movie. And then by the end, he understands that he is the bridge of the two worlds. And I'm still kind of like getting that together. And you're right. I am playing the younger brother of the two. And so basically, the character that I played, Suo, is just Peter.
Is it really?
Yeah. No, I drew a lot of inspiration from Peter. Oh. The way that Peter is very aloof to some stuff. He's like so chill, you know, and he's playful. I mean, there are serious moments, but he's like, it's okay. Like, it's all good. And then he's an artist. Suo's an artist. You kind of see that a little bit. And he's more of the poetic kind. And he plays a little bit more with the feelings, and he allows his feelings to show a little bit more. So I definitely drew inspiration from Peter.
I gotta ask you about some of the action in this movie. Now, I know that you are very well versed in stunts, because I've been to your stunt school, 8711, and it's pretty intense there. So talk to me about how that differs, though, from this action in this film, how that differs from the other stunts that you've done in the past. Because it's very stylistic, and it's a beautiful film.
So it wasn't that different from where I first started. My first entertainment job was as a stunt actor in the Wild West stunt show at Knott's Berry Farm. And that was my first thing ever, like, performing, acting, and doing stunts. So a lot of it was I had to gritty up, you know, these punches had to be a little bit heavier, and it was less, like, you know, pretty and martial artsy, which what Power Rangers was. And for this, it was a lot more like downright gritty. If you slip, you slip and you keep going.
Right.
And that was part of the choreo. You just enjoyed being messy. You know, it was like a punch didn't land. That's okay. You push the guy, you shove him. So it was fun. It was a lot of fun getting into it. And I would love to do more of it. I think we had just a taste. I think we needed a little more.
Now, as an actor, I'm sure that every project that you're on, you learn something new. What is it that you can take away from this experience from Buffalo Boys that you're going to be able to take with you for the rest of your career?
Well, first of all, this is my first time, you know, being on the big screen and right away being the number one on the call sheet. And I think the pressure that I had, like, thinking about all this, I had to learn to just let go of that and enjoy it as it is for what it is. And for my next projects, I need to just, again, like, enjoy it. Enjoy the time while it's there. And instead of, like, stressing too much about it and worrying about all this other stuff that's happening, you just need to be here and be with the character and be with the scene, whatever it is.
Now, Suo kind of leaves it open-ended when we get towards the end of possibly meeting up with his love interest in the film again. Do you think that if everything goes to plan, that there could be a Buffalo Boys too? Or maybe Buffalo Girls, as we said in the, I heard the Q&A.
I would love a sequel to this, but I've heard through the grapevines. I mean, we have a spinoff from this. That's a TV show, and it's all in English. It's going on HBO Go this month, actually. It's called Grease, and it's about the town over. And if that does well, second season, Buffalo Boys is coming in, and we're going to have like a team-up thing. So we're doing our own little team up. And if we get Buffalo Boys 2 before that happens, that would be amazing. Because I think the production design, the costumes were so cool that we couldn't just let it go away to nothing.
Right.
You know, we can't let it go to waste. Because, again, the leather armor for cowboys, how did nobody think of that? But now it's done and it looks so, so freaking cool. And I'm stoked.
Now, the one thing I do want to ask you about is, obviously, we've seen in this year specifically a lot of Asian leads in a lot of major films. Searching was one of my favorite movies of the year.
Oh, dude, so good.
It's a really good film.
That was so dope.
And obviously Crazy Rich Asians. Mm-hmm. And now we have Buffalo Boys. What are you hoping audiences can kind of see from this?
I'm just hoping to see that. I just want them to see that there are Asians of all kinds of different types. You know, again, that I said in the Q&A, it was, you know, we had Searching, that was the leading Asian man who played in a thriller.
And it doesn't have to be a trope. It could have been anybody, you know what I mean?
It could have been, those characters could have been anybody. And again, the Asian guy who's a cowboy, that's never, like, nobody ever fathomed that could be a thing, you know? All my Asian friends were like, oh, dude, you're a cowboy. I was like, I know, I've always wanted to be a cowboy. We all played cowboys when we were growing up, you know, with the whole guns. And so I think that I just want people to see all the different types of Asians that there are. Like, yes, we have the rom-com types. Yes, we have the bad, evil guys. And yes, we have the people who are there for the suspense and the family man. And then we have, you know, action, just downright fun action, gunslinging, cowboy, horse riding, buffalo riding, you know, that kind of stuff. So I think the most that I want people to get out of it is just all the different types of Asians that we are.
Exactly. And I know you were born in Indonesia and you moved here when you were very young. And I know a lot of the movie is also spoken in Indonesian. Chat me up about how the learning curve was for you, because I know that sometimes when you don't use a language often, it kind of fades.
So I moved to America when I was 8. So and when I came to America, I was bullied a lot for not speaking English. I didn't speak English at all. Zero English.
Well, you have, like, perfect English now. It's crazy.
Because I literally pushed away all of my Indonesian and completely stopped speaking it and just forced myself to speak English. And because we didn't have many people that we could speak Indonesian with, it was literally just my brother and my parents. And, you know, when your parents tell you to do something, you do the other thing.
Sure.
So I just completely spoke only in English and it completely faded away. But in the sense, I could understand it because my parents would speak it. But coming back to Indonesia, you know, the vocabulary that I had as an 8-year-old is nothing compared to what the movie was. You know, there's all these words that I was like, I don't even know what this means.
Sure.
I don't know how to say it. I need somebody to, and reading was even harder.
Wow.
Yeah, and the script was originally in English. So when they translated, I was like, please, can you please translate the description into English at least? And then let me read the dialogue, you know. And after this movie, I was able to do another movie in Indonesia, which has helped my Indonesian to improve even more so.
Now, my last question for you, and we were talking about this just a second ago, is like letting it sink in that this is up for Oscar contingency. And that's quite amazing. Congratulations on that, by the way.
Thank you.
But talk to me about how that must feel for you, because this is your first time on the big screen, but also with Oscar contingency as well. That's kind of crazy.
It blew me out of the water. I was completely baffled that this was even anywhere near the Oscar stuff. So I'm really excited to hear that people are taking, you know, a liking to this film, and I mean, from the crowd that we saw today, I was, you know, my heart is so warm from all of that. I don't know what to say about it. It's just, it's a really cool thing, you know, and I hope something comes of it.
Well, hopefully we'll find out soon enough. Buffalo Boys opens on January 11th nationwide. Check it out. Yoshi, thank you so much for joining us. And as an honor, as always, congratulations on all the success.
Always a pleasure.
Thank you.